We're back.
Welcome to Keto on the Couch, episode 70.
I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we're two crazy ketos.
And if you're new to our channel, welcome.
Yes, welcome to the more than 130 new subscribers since the last Keto on the Couch.
Now here on Two Crazy Ketos, we do different things like recipe videos, we do product reviews, we talk about various keto topics, and then every Monday, we sit down on the couch for Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us in different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com. That's where you're going to find all of our different recipes. Now, we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week, so make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon, and that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
So, should we get the elephant out of the room right now?
Let's do it.
We are not on the couch.
But if you have been with us for any length of time or you want to go back and look at some of the old Keto in the Couches, we used to do Keto on the Couch on a couch.
Yeah, we did. But for the last 3 months, right, yeah, during this whole COVID thing, we have been doing Keto on the Couch live, which was great. A lot of people were home, so they were able to catch us live. It helped us out. It freed up our weekends a little bit. But there was something missing with it being, you know, on the couch or recorded. We were not getting the same thing where we can really message with you guys and you could leave comments on the video. And it was kind of torn, right? 50-50. Half of the people wanted us to stay live.
Right.
And half of them wanted us to bring Keto on the Couch back to a pre-recorded format.
Well, I mean, you can always have like an extra live stream during the week.
Right.
Like, we can always do that.
Right.
But it also felt a little bit weird for me that there would be people watching and chatting and I'm just like ignoring that.
Right.
Because it's not a traditional live stream where you're chatting back and forth with people. So yeah, it was weird.
So one of the things that we decided what we're going to do is, again, what we really liked about Keto on the Couch was this was the episode that talked about what we did throughout the week, like what kind of food we had, what like challenge we had. But it also was the episode that we like to celebrate you guys,
yeah,
our viewers and subscribers.
Spotlight them.
And we felt like we were missing that because if you weren't able to join us live, you kind of got left behind a little bit.
Yeah. Well, and we thought we were going back to church and having it in a building. And so we thought, well, our schedule is changing, so this is the perfect time to like take it back to a pre-recorded thing. Of course, we had no idea, you know, how our week would change as soon as we like made that proclamation. But it's like anything, when you have intention, you're like, you decide to do something before you see the fruition of it, right?
Right, right. So here is our compromise. We're gonna bring Keto on the Couch back to sort of video on Monday, but yeah, we're not gonna go back to the couch.
Yeah.
We decided that we're gonna keep it Keto on the Couch as the name, but we're gonna film it here in the studio on the bench. And the reason is we're trying to make it a little bit more professional. So we're bringing some of the elements that we had in the live stream over to here, like having this little overlay or bringing up the comments on a graphic.
Look at those little avocados right there.
Or the fact that now we can have an extra camera.
I love that. You can see how dirty my room is.
So one of the things that we were not able to do when we were on the couch was that because we had to move all the cameras. Now we have the computer here. We have the screen here. So we're going to leave it here. And then the compromise for everybody who wanted us to have Keto on the Couch live, we're going to add another live stream in during the week.
But it's
going to
float.
But it's going to float.
Because
it's going to depend on our schedule. So we're going to keep the one Thursday nights, 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
That one you can take to the bank.
Unless we're traveling or something, that one is always going to be there. And if we have to change it because like we have a meeting or something like that, we're always going to give you guys like a week's head notice. Like,
yeah,
hey, you know, we've got to change up like this day and move it to Wednesday or make it earlier or later or something like that.
Yeah.
But the other one we're going to add.
Ooh, when will it happen?
It's going to be different.
I don't know.
As a matter of fact, if you're watching this Keto on the Couch right now on Monday, you may not know that you missed our surprise live stream because it was yesterday.
Yeah.
So as soon as we're done filming this, we're going to jump on a live. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to find another one that we can throw in somewhere during the week. For the most part, we're going to give you guys like an hour or two notice, but sometimes we may just feel like, hey,
let's hop on.
Let's jump on and say hello to everybody.
I want to talk to people.
And whenever possible, we are going to try to do it on a weekend because there's people so many awesome people like Heath and Shelly who, you know, they're working and they weren't able to join us for the lives. So that's the plans for the channel. Anything else? Anything else that we need to talk about?
I have no plans.
Well, a lot of people I did want to mention have asked us like, hey, how can I support you guys? And there's a few ways. Number one, we have a Patreon.
We do.
And don't feel obligated, but if you want to throw a couple of dollars to help us support the channel, that is one way. We have affiliate links down below as well as on our website. And here's the cool thing about affiliate links. This is why I like them. If you use them, it doesn't cost you anything.
Right.
It throws a dollar or $2, anywhere between 5 to 10% towards us. But also, if you use, for example, one of our Amazon links, what's nice is even if you don't buy that product, let's say you don't like the, I don't know, blender that we use, that we recommend, but if you click on that and then buy a different blender, we still get like a 0.5% or something like that.
Thank you for that.
So those are awesome ways that you guys can support, and we really do appreciate you guys doing that. We try to always be around for you guys, and your supporting us in those ways definitely helps us. Speaking of deals.
Okay.
This week we have a couple of deals. We always like to spotlight some of the deals that we know of. This week's deal for Keto Chow.
Yes.
Is your favorite flavor.
Not root beer.
No. Orange cream.
I actually like orange cream.
You didn't at first.
I didn't at first. I think that orange cream is like a lemon. It is a summer flavor.
Okay, I can take that.
And I am a huge fan of mixing it with coconut oil and turning it into a frosty beverage because it really tastes like a tropical drink when you do that. Now, right. A lot of people just like it as almost like a creamsicle, mix it with the heavy cream or the butter and get more of a traditional orange cream flavor. But I really like it as a tropical drink.
Okay. Well, this week's flavor of the week is orange cream. It's 10% off over on Keto Chow. We do have a link down below. You automatically will get 10% off when you click through that link. So every no matter time. What you're buying, you're always going to get 10% off using that link.
I like that.
One of our subscribers also posted a really cool deal if you're living down south.
If you have a Publix.
If you have a Publix.
It's enlightened.
It's enlightened
ice cream. Buy one, get one free.
Buy one, get one free enlightened ice cream. So we love enlightened ice cream. We have it once in a while as a little treat. And if you haven't seen, we've actually got a couple of review videos. I'll leave a link to that over Rachel's head.
The bars are where it is at for me personally, because I know exactly how much I'm supposed to be eating. It's all mine. I don't have to share and I don't have to wait for us to like open and enlightened, let it thaw out a little bit. And if he doesn't want any, put it back into the freezer.
Yeah, I'm the same way. I really like the bars and for a couple reasons. Number one, the biggest reason is definitely it's portioned out for me.
Yeah.
Because as much as I try to with any keto ice cream, whether we make it ourselves or we buy, you know, the Enlightened or we buy the Killer Creamery or the Rebel Creamery, I try not to, but I do play the little game of like I weigh it out, but I usually end up with at least one extra spoon in my mouth.
Yeah.
As, oh, I got to make sure that this is like defrosted properly or something like that.
You know what else I like about them is the way that they're shaped. I know this may be just like a girl thing, but aesthetically, they're like very pretty and chunky.
Okay.
They look kind of like avocado-y. And they look very expensive. When you would get like the Häagen-Dazs bars, they were that kind of shape where it was like a chunky pop. I don't know. I just like that the way that they're shaped.
Also, you don't have to leave them out as long. You really can take them out and right away start eating them. But if you really want that nice soft ice cream consistency, it's 2 or 3 minutes just sitting on the counter. Like take it out, pour yourself a cup of coffee, go get yourself situated on your bed or at the table or wherever you're having to eat it. And by then, it's the perfect consistency as opposed to having to take out the pints, let it sit for 15, 20 minutes. I would love to see all of the different keto ice creams have a bar form factor because yes. I just love the bar form factor. So if you do have a Publix anywhere near you, yeah, they're buy one, get one free through Wednesday of this week.
Okay, so I love that you mentioned go get a cup of coffee, go situated, get situated in where you're going to sit and eat it. I need all food to be able to give me that time. I need hot food to give me a minute. Don't cool down until I have a chance to get a drink, to get my Redmond Real Salt, to get whatever I'm dipping with, and then get situated in my bed or at my table, right? Wouldn't that be nice if all food would just give me a little bit of time? I may have to pee one more time before I eat. Like, give me that time.
Speaking of coffee.
Yes.
So I was watching, you went on your date with Anthony today.
I did.
Like every Sunday. This is like one of the positive things of COVID, right?
Yeah, if there's such a thing.
When we got into lockdown and we had to go to church online, you know, but prior to this, we spent all Sunday at church,
right?
Everybody, Rachel would get there at like 5 in the morning. I would get there about 5:30, 6 o'clock, and Anthony would get there, and we were there all day.
But you're in your lane. Like, he would be, we would each be teaching in different classes, and you really didn't get that like Sunday interaction. We weren't even able to go to church together as a family because we were serving in different services. Right. There's 4 different services going on Sundays. And so, like, we did not see each other. So Anthony reached out and he was like, hey, we're actually both home right now, not like cutting grass or, you know, doing stuff. If I'm doing something different, shipping. He's like, we're home together. Why don't we go out? Like, me and you, just mom, son, date day. And it was like, of course, when your 20-year-old son even wants to hang out with you, you're right. Like, we're doing it. So yeah, it just became a habit. And I was actually...
And you've got a standing thing with Caleb too, right? On Fridays, there's a show that comes out that...
Central Park.
As soon as it comes out, you watch it.
It's on Apple. If you have like the Apple TV, it's mm-hmm. free. And it is a funny show. And it's got like singing and stuff, which we're all about cartoons and singing. So yeah, it was something that we can do together. And I was actually a little bit bummed, not bummed to go back to the church building, but bummed that Anthony and I wouldn't have that time together again, but we're not going back quite yet. And so we do have time to go together. So yeah, we went out today.
So while Rachel was, you know, out on her little date with Anthony, I had to go to BJ's because I needed...
And Dick's. You know, they're across the street from each other.
Actually, the BJ's I went to doesn't have a Dick's across the street, but the other BJ's does have one.
It's there.
It might be down the street.
Look harder.
Can I get back to this?
Yeah.
So we don't get demonetized again.
Go for it.
So I went to BJ's because we needed a laundry detergent, which, by the way, if you don't have a lot of coupons and good sales on laundry detergent, BJ's always has really good deals because they have coupons, so long as you're not brand loyal.
I don't like when Joe goes for
laundry
detergent.
That's another discussion.
Because he always tries to find unscented.
No, I don't. I just got an unscented because it was ridiculously cheap. But I also bought the other ones.
Okay, yes, thank you.
This is another video. This will take us... We had already an hour discussion with the children about this. Can I move on?
Scented laundry detergent is where it's at, and he's like, it doesn't matter. It's
Let us know down below. What do you
think? Scented laundry detergent.
If you are putting some kind of smell good stuff into the dryer, or if you're using... fabric softener, which we don't use anymore.
We're using
the dryer balls with a really good smell stuff that you get from Whole Foods, right? So if you're putting that stuff in, do you think it matters if your laundry detergent itself is unscented?
Now, obviously...
Because I say it doesn't matter if it's unscented because you're adding scent in the dryer.
And I am saying that unless... You obviously, if someone has like a skin issue or they're highly allergic to stuff and they can't have anything, you know, or you're making, you know, you're washing baby clothes and so you're using like maybe Dreft or something that has no scent, like take out any type of skin issues or allergies, which we do not have.
Okay, I have allergies. Okay. Wait a second. I had an allergy attack yesterday, so.
It had nothing to do with the laundry detergent. Okay, do not listen to him. Okay. So if skin issues and allergies are not a factor, do you want your laundry detergent to smell like something good?
And I agree, except for that it was half price.
Right, I get it.
And when you're getting three times as many of the pods for half the price of everybody else. I picked up one container.
I still want my laundry detergent to smell like
something.
Can
we get back to why I was going, what I was doing? So I went to BJ's and Dr. Siwas had a great video, which I'm going to link right over Rachel's head. You would have loved this. It was all about how, listen, why we snack. Why do we snack? We snack for an emotional reason, right?
Yeah.
So we're not snacking because we're hungry. We're snacking for a high. And he talked about that. He used to drink a case of soda a day. And when you, a lot of times, like he's talking about, like when you're drinking three times, like you drink for three different reasons. And he's talking about you drink for thirst, you're drinking for that high, you know? And so he was talking about how coffee is awesome because it's zero calorie.
Okay.
And that he is drinking coffee like every 20 minutes.
Wow.
Because that's replaced his soda.
He may be my brother from another mother.
I figured you would like that.
I do love that. And I will say right off the bat, there is plenty of times, and let us know if you guys do the same thing. I am drinking so that I will not eat. But I need something going on in my mouth.
And that's what he was talking
about. That sounds crazy. So I used to chew gum so that I didn't eat. Right? So I stopped chewing gum because there are, like, you know, a bunch of carbs, especially if you're like me. If you're chewing one stick of gum or three sticks of gum a day like a normal human being, then yeah, go for it. But for me, eating a pack or more a day, I sound like cigarettes, right? Like, but I was devouring gum because I wanted to eat that many times. So I switched to drinking soda myself, I've done in the past. And so I would go through a ton of soda. Now, it wasn't so much that I was worried even about the ingredients in the soda. I was more concerned about the cost. Like, I could go, if I'm going through a 12 pack of soda and we're not getting it on sale,
right?
That's a lot of money. But yeah, I could make coffee, I can get it cheap, can make a whole pot and drink a whole pot.
And that's what exactly he was talking about. He's talking about that if you have that thing when you're not supposed to be eating, because you're not drinking for what it's intended for, which is to nourish your thirst.
Well, and
you're drinking because you want to eat.
Yeah.
And so don't drink sugary sodas and juices. Right. That when you have that, find that, he calls it a bridge, and his bridge is coffee. And he's like, I've started relying heavily on that because every time I want to eat, I just take a sip of coffee. Not a cup of coffee, a sip of coffee.
Oh, a sip? Well, he's much more in control of his behavior than I am.
Okay, let's move on. So you did mention we had to go, we're not going back to church.
It was so close to the finish line here. I mean, we were really like, we had everything in place. I have every single classroom set up. Like, we, everything has been cleaned and scrubbed down. We have the stickers on the floor in order to social distance. We have a new entrance for kids and exit for kids. I mean, everything was in place. And then the county has changed a little bit about, you know, how many people are supposed to meet and what. And then also, just as we've had numbers go up here in Florida of cases, we just decided better safe than sorry.
That's right.
Go ahead and stay
online.
Well,
not online, us, the leadership of the church.
Which I think was a good call. Mm-hmm. Honestly, I think it was the best call. Mm-hmm. And so we're back online. So we had to tape from the series, the Epic series that we were already taping. We couldn't switch and go to a new series. It was a lot of changes, and I felt like you and I did so well not going into a snack and food spiral, because here's the thing. My eating has nothing to do with my workplace. It has absolutely nothing to do with my workplace. And yet, when you switch up stuff at work, and I don't think we're alone in this, you switch up the schedule, if there's any change in my life plan, I immediately handle it in the refrigerator, handle it on my plate.
I'm the same way.
It's so
unless
weird.
I get busy, which this was actually good for me because it got me so busy, I stopped thinking about food.
Yeah.
And I was going a really long time without eating, you know, like waiting till 6-7 o'clock because all of a sudden we had things going on. But one of the things that this really brought up was we were talking about like being persistent and having stamina because you have to get things done.
Yeah.
Because another example was this past weekend, Anthony and I have been working on the chicken coop. It has to get done.
Big. They're ready.
They're big. They're huge. Their dust baths are putting dust all over, like, the garage, to the point where we actually had to put on hold for a couple of days, like, making some t-shirts that I need to make because their dust and stuff is everywhere, and that's where my t-shirt press is, and I don't want to send you guys t-shirts that are covered dusty with dust, right? So, but you have to have that stamina to keep going through. So what happened was is we're making the chicken coop, and the skies just kept opening up. So it's like, well, what else can we do? And we're just, you know what? It's got to get done.
You're like waiting there by the window. As soon as it opens again for you to be able to work, you're back in it. And mm-hmm. it's the same thing for me. Like, so in July, we have posed a movement challenge. Yep. Basically, like, we have the freedom after losing 100 pounds to be able to move, to be able to exercise. So I set the challenge for myself, 10,000 steps a day.
Right.
And from the moment I set a goal for myself to walk those 10,000 steps that I made as a challenge for myself, there has been an obstacle that has presented itself every single day. Either my schedule got pushed back and I wasn't able to start until it is in that realm of super duper hot outside, mm-hmm. or it has rained, or someone has needed something from me and I have to like put it off till later. And I have had to push past whatever is going on and be like, I've determined I'm getting that in. This is something that I am doing for myself and I'm going to do it.
Right.
And it's kind of the same with even your eating plan or keto. If you are waiting for everything to be completely calm and no hiccups in the day to stay on track as far as your eating plan, your exercise plan, or even your intentionality with relationships, that is not going to happen. I can tell you, spoiler alert, right now, life is going to throw a toolbox full of wrenches mm-hmm. in that plan. So you just have to decide, hey, this has got to be done. I'm going to have to put my big girl pants on and just move forward with whatever your goal is.
Right. So my question is, what do you do when you hit one of these little obstacles that could stop you like from doing whatever you're working on? Like if you're working outside and the skies open up, or maybe like you want to eat a certain type of food in the house and then you realize I'm missing that. Are you finding a way to substitute with another keto product? Or are you like, you know what? I'm just going to not eat keto today.
Because I can tell you, for a good 20 years of my life, you know what my response was to obstacles?
What?
Abandon the project. Abandon it. Abandon my goals. Stop what I'm doing and just give in to whatever happens. Mm-hmm. And I would always connect food to whatever goal it was. So when we talk about, you know, my job has nothing to do with my dinner plate, and yet I always connected the two.
Right.
Whenever there was an obstacle, you know, in a goal, it connected to my dinner plate. And if it was something to do with health or fitness, I abandoned the project.
Yeah. So, I mean, today years. Is what, July 13th?
Yeah.
How many people have abandoned their Get Moving? I've, the last few days, because we got so busy, abandoned the Get Moving. But you know what? I'm going to get back on track now. I'm not going to let that step, you know, in my way and stop me from moving for the rest of the month. I've still got more than half of month left
yes.
to get back moving, and that's what I'm going to do. So I'm curious, have any of you had the same thing? Let us know down below. Are you ready to get to some subscriber of the weeks and comments?
Always. This is my favorite part.
Before we do this, let's take a quick commercial break. Now, if you do have the YouTube Premium, you're not going to have a commercial break.
Well, welcome back. After those messages, we came right back.
Well, guys, thank you for sticking with us. Let's get into the subscriber of the weeks. I did want to mention, though, before we even do that, if you aren't already subscribed, please hit that little subscribe button down below and hit the little like button on this video.
It's very easy to do, but it does a lot for the channel.
Yeah, it helps us grow. The more interaction there is when you guys leave comments, hit the like button, subscribe, and that little bell notification.
Yes.
That's where YouTube starts recommending us to more people. And our whole goal is to get the content into as many people as possible because we want to change lives.
Yeah.
And that's the focus of this channel, like being the family for people to help change their lives.
And that's why we're always saying that all the time.
That's right.
Like a broken record.
So let's get into, so we have a couple of subscribe, we have a couple of like little update kind of things, non-scale victories, and then we have a subscriber of the week. So the first one is going to be from Vivid J.
Also known as Jason.
Also known as Jason.
To his family that named him, not Vivid J, but Jason.
So Jason put on our Facebook last week, he said, today's my birthday, 3 years ago, beard with his daughter. I guess he had a beard in that photo. 2 years ago with his sister, and then just before he started dieting, and then another picture of today.
Happy birthday. This year even feels more special for his birthday.
Well, do you want to show the picture?
Yes, please. Look at that. Oh my gosh, you forget how far he has come. Because you see pictures of him now. He's really great about posting pictures of what's going on right now, but you have to look back and see. I mean, you look like a distant relative of yourself, Jason. Amazing.
Now, we actually did a little interview with Jason because he overcame a lot of different medical problems and things like that. So if you haven't seen that, I'll leave a link for it over Rachel's head. It was really awesome. Are you going to say happy birthday to him, though? Because we did miss his birthday.
Yes, let's do that. What I was going to say is he's an incredible person.
He really is.
We love him. All right, so let's sing happy birthday.
Okay.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy belated birthday to Vivid J.
Happy birthday to you. You screwed me up there.
And many, many more.
You ready for the next one?
Yes, please.
So Shauna wrote,
hey Shauna.
Non-scale victories. This little box used to hold my insulin, syringes, and alcohol swabs, and now it holds electrolyte drops, H2O flavorings, and essential oils.
Oh my goodness.
Never give up.
Wow.
Here we go.
Oh my gracious. Do I love this thing being totally repurposed. Wow. Wow. Oh my gosh.
Okay, now we do have one subscriber of the week. Now, if you're new to our channel, we do like to celebrate all of our different subscribers, like any of your successes, even if you're in the middle of your journey.
Yes, because that is worth celebrating.
Yeah, you don't have to be like at the finish line and in maintenance mode. If you're 10 pounds down, that is an accomplishment, and we like to celebrate that. And also, it helps encourage other people. There's somebody out there right now that is going through the same thing that you're going through or went through, you know, what you've gone through. And when you share your story, it encourages them to keep going.
It is.
So make sure you're a member of our Facebook family group. There's a link for it down below, and you can share your story on there. And if you don't have Facebook, you can email us at stories@twocrazyketos.com.
I don't think people realize how inspirational and motivational that they are, but your exact issue and your exact story is what's going to bless somebody else in a way that we cannot.
Right. And just a little bit of selfishness. A lot of times their stories keep me going.
Same here. Oh my goodness. They keep you moving. Yes. And it gives
me. So I want them just to keep me going.
Well, and it gives me no excuse, right? There is no whining and complaining when you see like Shauna's box repurposed, no longer holding her things for diabetes, but like has a whole new, you know, purpose.
Right.
I want to keep going. No excuses.
Right. Okay, so this week's subscriber of the week is Amber.
Hey, Amber.
And Amber wrote, today versus July 25th, 2019. I've only lost about 17 pounds between those photos, from 47% body fat to 37%. And if my math is good, this means that I've lost about 27 pounds of fat and I've put on 12 pounds of muscle.
Wow.
5 inches off of my belly button, 6 inches off of the bra line, and 3 inches off of my hips.
Wow.
She said, I should try on that t-shirt dress again. Still more to go, but I think I should celebrate the journey.
Heck yes.
I could not have done this without the support and advice from the keto community. And thank you for my new mental clarity and my positive mood and the strength to carry the kitty litter down to the basement by myself. Onward. And here's her pictures.
Let me take a look. Oh my gracious. Amber, what a huge, amazing difference. I mean, you're saying only 17 pounds, but 5 inches around your waist makes a huge difference.
You look incredible.
Incredible.
So let's move on. We have a few comments. Again, now that we're back to being on like tape, we should have more comments that we can read and stuff like that. But there's a few. We pulled some from Facebook and some from YouTube. And the first one came from Boomer.
Hey, Boomer.
And Boomer said, oh my goodness, Miss Rachel was working that line from 69 to great smelling balls, balls, balls. I was laughing so hard when poor Joe just buried his head in his hand about the balls. I can count on Miss Rachel to make me laugh. She never fails to keep it spicy and entertaining. Laughter is good for the soul and the heart. God bless y'all.
I cannot help myself. And we talked about this before we went from Keto on the Couch tape to Lives. Lives with Rachel unedited can be dangerous a little bit. He spent an entire marriage rolling his eyes at me because, like, yes.
I usually think it's funny, except for it does get us in trouble with YouTube.
We do.
And they did demonetize that video.
It was so worth it, though.
And I had to go back and ask them to remonetize it. It takes a day. We already don't make much money off of YouTube.
Please, you have to be like, please, because my wife, please, come spend an afternoon with her and you'll see my pain.
Okay, next one. It is from Married to Keto.
Hey, Married to Keto.
And she said, I love how Joe explained why he doesn't eat keto bread. Totally avoid it if it causes you inflammation. For those that it doesn't cause inflammation for, you can eat it since it may not affect your ketones. It all depends on what you want from your diet.
It's funny. There was a really funny Goody Beats video that he had put on Instagram where he was like, if you have asked him to be your coach and then someone's coming out of a fast food place and he's swatting the food out of their hand. And it was hilarious, mm-hmm. right? I am never going to come to your house and swat something out of your hand. So feel free, if it is something that you want or something that you're doing, we cannot stop you.
Right.
Right? Like, even if we say we don't do it or we don't advise it, I'm never preventing anybody from doing what they want, right?
Right.
Like, you have the ability to do what you want. So don't worry about that. We just share what our experience is and what we do. And sometimes, I mean, we get a real backlash from people who are like, are you trying to take my stuff from me?
Right. I mean, it comes down to, like, I talked about it with the bread. I don't do it because, number one, it's going to trigger me. That's number one. Number two, the ingredients aren't good. It's not about ketones. It's not about glucose. I can tell you right now, if I went and ate the Aldi's bread or the Costco bread or any of these other Sola breads, I know if I took a blood glucose measurement, if I took a measurement using a CGI, if I checked my ketones,
yep.
I'm not going to have a change. I've never said that they're going to make a change in your levels, but they aren't good ingredients. Wheat is inflammatory.
Yeah.
One of the things about keto is it's an anti-inflammatory diet. That's why it works so well, mm-hmm. because it reduces your inflammation. That's why it helps, you know, people who have had cancer and different things like that. It's reducing some of that inflammation. When you introduce wheat back into it, you're reintroducing that inflammation. It's just like the bad oils. Can you have canola oil, corn oil, sunflower oil, all of these different oils on keto? Yes.
Yeah.
Are they going to decrease your ketones? No. They could even increase your ketones. Are they going to affect your blood sugar? No. But they're going to cause inflammation.
And here's the thing, at least in my experience, when I don't feel good because my joints hurt and I've got pains and aches and I've got inflammation in my body, it tends to affect my food choices throughout the day. Like, when you're sick and you're like, you know what? I just don't care. I'm hurting right now. I'm going to just eat whatever I want and not think about it. Like, right. I've made bad food choices and decisions and eaten off of, you know, my calorie plan and my meal plan because I didn't feel good.
Right.
So if over and over again, every single day, I'm eating inflammatory oils and getting that joint pain and that inflammation, chances are I'm going to go off plan.
Mm-hmm.
And that's usually why we speak out about it, because we just know it sets you up to fail in other areas.
Yeah. So, I mean, again, that's my biggest problem with the keto breads or and even the oils. They fall into the same category. I think that there are plenty of options out there. If you miss bread, you can have like a Fox Hills bread. You can make some of your own bread. Are they going to have a couple of carbs in them? Yes. I think you're better off with having 2 or 3 net carbs than eating a 0 net carb made in a lab kind of product.
Exactly.
That's just my personal opinion. honestly, if you really miss bread, if somebody is going to eat that, I'd rather you just go like make some homemade wheat bread and eat that over that, because there's not that many difference in the total carbs. Go look at it. The total carbs are not that different between those keto breads and a regular bread.
We don't want to take your bread, but we also don't want bread to take your success.
That's right. Okay, next one we have is from April.
Hey, April.
You want to read this one?
Sure. She says, I have an intermittent fasting question. Do you do it every single day, meaning stop eating at, say, 8 p.m. and don't eat again until noon? Or is it like a one day on, one day off sort of thing? I've been watching different YouTube videos on it from Dr. Barry, Thomas DeLauer, etc. But I'm more confused now than I was before. Help.
Well, I'm going to tell you, I think you're on the right track. Those are the two people that I would be listening to, and that's who we listen to. And it's a combination of both of them. I do believe that it's good to switch your body up. I don't think you should ever do anything regimented with your body, with your diet, anything like that, because our body is an amazing machine.
It adapts. It learns. It's a learning computer for sure.
And it's a creature of habit. So, for example, this is something that Rachel did. If you eat too little calories for too long of a period, your body is going to be like, hey, I need more energy, but she's not giving me more energy. So I'm going to start shutting things off and slowing things down so that I can operate on what she's giving me.
It also is a great saver. I wish I was as good of a saver as my body is.
Yeah.
So that if it says, you know what, I think I may need to like squirrel some energy away for later, I will somehow find a way to take some extra fat and calories out of what she's giving me, even if it seems like she's giving me almost nothing.
Right. And the thing, it's really cool about that is, if you don't eat anything, your body is really good about using like what it's got stored.
Yeah.
But when you start giving it just a little bit or not enough on a regular basis, i.e. eat 1,100 calories a day for 3, 4, 5 weeks, your body will start slowing down metabolism. That's what causes the stalls. I think it's the same thing when it comes to your intermittent fasting. If you are eating at the same exact times every single day, first of all, your body develops a habit and it starts releasing hormones at that time, like, hey, you need to eat. But if you were to wait just 30 minutes, you'd realize you really weren't hungry. So when you're constantly switching it up, your body doesn't quite know what to do and it's always like on the ready. And Thomas DeLauer talks a lot about that. Now you can also go into Dr. Barry. He doesn't necessarily talk about intermittent fasting as much as like Thomas DeLauer, but what he does see, you eat when you're hungry.
Yeah.
Not when you're emotionally hungry, when you're physically hungry.
Not when your ghrelin hormone is telling you you're hungry.
Right.
When you're actually hungry.
So that means that one day you may be hungry at noon. One day, like for example, yesterday, we didn't eat until 7 o'clock at night. Now we were slightly hungry, but we were in the middle of doing some work.
But I didn't kill nobody.
But we didn't kill anybody. We were fine. I know at around 3 o'clock at our normal time of eating, we were both like, boy, I really want to eat. And then I looked at Rachel, I'm like, I don't want to stop because the sun just came back out. And she's like, you know what? Keep going. And we waited a half hour and we were completely fine. And I think that, so when Dr. Barry talks about eat when you're hungry, it's you're never really on a schedule. He's not regimenting you like you're going to eat today at 3 o'clock every single day or today at 11 o'clock every single day. Because today at 11 o'clock, you may not be hungry.
Exactly.
Next, we have Melissa.
Hey, Melissa.
Melissa said, I love Hint water. Most of the flavored waters have too strong of a flavor for me. I like the seltzer waters too, but sometimes I don't want the carbonation. I do agree about flat sodas though, because those are meant to be carbonated and they are gross when they're flat. My fiance will open a 2-liter and not put the top back on all the way, which drives me crazy.
That's a declaration of war right there. Like seriously, you've got to keep the carbonated stuff carbonated. I totally get what she's saying. And I think that I would love to not drink so much carbonated stuff, because I definitely think that it adds to my bloat. Mm-hmm. And I mean, it's, I don't think that it's a coincidence that I will eat like a bunch of wings or something like that, or something spicy, and then all of a sudden need to chase that with like four or five, you know, seltzer waters. Like, why do I suddenly need that? Why can't I just drink flat water, like plain water with nothing in it, would be what I really need to drink.
It goes back to, it's like, it's triggering like a happiness for yourself.
Isn't that crazy?
That's why you're doing it.
But yeah, the hint water is definitely for Joe and not for me. And it's so funny because
I would not buy it. I bought it for Rachel. Caleb, it's okay, but it's definitely not a favorite.
Caleb tried it and he was like, is it okay if I have one of these like hint waters? And I was like, take them all. And he was like, what do you mean? I love them. And I was like, are you actually my child? Like, because yeah, he loves them.
Next, we have Adaliza, or Delisa.
She says, I use the same feet in cool water and on the wrist trick to cool down as well. I also like an ice mask when I sleep. I have never tried that.
No. I'm not looking over you with an ice mask on your face.
Like Batman. I mean, usually you look over when we're shopping and I've got my bottom of my face covered. What if I just have the top of my face covered?
So if you didn't see last week, we were talking about like one of the little tricks that I have as an official when it's really hot out, especially during the summer, is if you're outside, if you're really hot, take a little bit of water and just a few little drops on your wrists and you will immediately start cooling down. It's amazing what it does to you.
It is amazing. It's truly amazing.
Next up is Kim.
Hey, Kim. She says, hey, Joe, I have a question. I've made your yogurt recipe twice. First time, really tasty and great consistency. Second batch, it was so thick, it was like eating cream cheese. Okay, so that's not a bad day for me. Did I strain it for too long? I had it in the fridge for 48 hours. Thanks.
Yeah, you probably strained it too long, although personally, that's how we like it. I let it strain for about 24 hours. It also comes down to how much of the live cultures you put in to start and how long you let it go. So the more live cultures you put in the start, like let's say instead of using 1 or 2 tablespoons of, you know, starter yogurt, you use 3 or 4. That's introducing more live cultures, which means they're going to be able to eat up the sugars and the milk a little bit faster. Or if instead of stopping at 8 hours, you go 10, 12, 14, you know, 20 hours. So all of those are components and will affect the final consistency. So what I kind of do is say, just check it as you go along. We like it really thick. Not quite cream cheese, but close to it. Like very spreadable. I don't want it.
Do the upside down trick.
Yeah, you got to be able to take a spoon and turn it upside down and have it sit there and not come off. And if it's coming off, then I'm going to let it go a little bit longer.
Although I'm a little bit sad because now we use that like container to strain it and not our old nut milk bags. I miss opening up my refrigerator and seeing a bunch of nut milk bags.
Next up, Pat wrote, I'm doing a colonoscopy cleanse and I plan to use the Redmond Relight instead of, or at least in addition to, the Powerade Zero. How much do you think I would need to use throughout the day? I normally do a little less than 1 scoop throughout the day, but I will be flushing out so much that I wonder if 2 scoops throughout the day might be best.
Well, first of all, I think that that is a great switch up from Powerade Zero to the Redmond Real Light. I think you're going to be really happy about the ingredients.
Mm-hmm. Now, yeah, what I would say, you're not going to overdo it. Your body is going to tell you you've had enough electrolytes. I drink at least 2 scoops of that usually a day. I'll drink that when I want some kind of flavor because I know at least I'm giving myself some of the electrolytes and the sodium and stuff like that. You know, the Powerade is there. They're trying to increase your sodium because you're cleansing. And again, they're trying to give you electrolytes because if you were too fast without adding any electrolytes in, then you're going to start experiencing headaches and, you know, maybe a little dizziness, a little bit of light, you know, headedness and
but you're
cramps.
Not going to have that like but, because of keto.
If you're doing the Redmond's, it's going to be the same thing. So I would stick with either the 1 or the 2. You know, at least they're telling you to do Powerade Zero. I personally wouldn't even do that. But if a doctor was telling me, like, I have to drink Powerade, I would just find something else.
That's, yeah.
But again, we're not doctors or medical professionals. I'm just never going to do sugar, even if a doctor tells me that I need to do sugar. That's just my personal opinion.
I've always wanted to wear the lab coat. But yeah, we're not doctors.
No. Well, that's going to be the last comment for this week. We really do appreciate you guys joining us. I don't know. I'm kind of torn between it being live and being back on video, but I think it's going to work out well in the end.
I think it will be too, and I think it gives everybody more chances to like put comments on our Instagram page, put them in the Facebook family group, you know, put them on the YouTube video so that we can spotlight them and that everybody can kind of be present in the moment when we're reading them.
So yeah, make sure you leave a comment down below. You can answer any of the questions that we post today, or if you have a question that we didn't talk about, leave it down below and we'll make sure we talk about it on next week's Keto on the Couch. Now, if you do like these kind of videos, you can click right over here and see some of our old Keto on the Couches, or you can check out our most recent video, which is right down here.
But either way, don't forget to subscribe to our channel right here so that you can find out about all of the videos that we have coming up.
Okay, until next week, guys. Bye.